Some legends are told, some turn to dust or to gold, but you will remember me. Remember me for
sunshine. DJ Khaled, hey,
yeah.
And they stay there, and they say yeah, and they stay there. Cause all I do is win, win, win. And if you going in, put your hands in the air, make them stay there.
Ludacris going in on the verse, cause I never been defeated and I won't stop now. Keep your hands up, get them in the sky for the homies that ain't making it, my folks locked down. I never went nowhere. What they saying,
saying very little, so he's agreed to let me ramble. And like the child in the Family Circus cartoons, I hope to bring it home eventually. Mark, I'd like to thank you again for your hospitality. It goes back 6 months for you to prepare, and no matter how difficult certain of us try to make it by throwing little details in, you make it fly, and you make us all feel so special. This is a very special day for us, and for our families. Second, I'm so proud of what the school's doing, you know, with the facilities and the development. It's a great recruiting tool. For Coach, one of our star recruits, my sophomore year, I think we got him because he was allowed to misunderstand that Prescott was the coast of Florida. And so we got Troy Bingham from Durban City, South Africa. It all worked out so tremendously. But we're so happy the coaches have more resources available to them nowadays to bring really fine student athletes here. And Chris, hearing you speak, we're really proud of you, and we're really proud of all the student athletes here at Gannon. You represent the school so well. I'd like to talk about the team. And I feel, I don't have any prepared remarks, I'm kind of speaking from the heart, because for this group, you know, it's been 25 and a half years. So this was, thankfully, a great reunion opportunity, and it's been memories and emotions. And to try to script that, I'm not an eloquent speaker to begin with, but just kind of speak from the heart here. But I feel like I'm in a position to speak about the players because, you know, I was one of the three goalkeepers on the team, and I've said it before, I cannot think of a position in sports that is more dependent upon the group, more dependent upon the team than a goalkeeper. You know, how goes the team? There goes I. And I look at the faces here, and I have a lot of memories of the games and the practices. And Mike and Chris and I, the three goalkeepers, before you could get to us, you had to get through all of them. And it didn't happen that often. On the field, it was an amazingly gifted and talented group of individuals. But off the field, you know, off the field, my experience with this group of men, that's what Gannon is all about. I have three memories of my first day here at Gannon. And the first one was seeing the back of my mom and dad walking away from me very quickly to find out that my dad grabbed my mom's hand and said, "Don't look back, don't look back, don't look back." My second memory was I was sitting in a quad, you know, in the Worley Hall. A quad is one of the dorm rooms where it accommodates four people. And I'm sitting across from this kid, and he's very representative of the very diverse experience that Gannon University, particularly the soccer team, provides. You've heard about where all these guys came from. And this kid was talking to me for 5 or 10 minutes, and I didn't understand a word this kid was saying. And I'm just looking at him. I'd never experienced such a thing before. So I'm kind of... And after a while, he says, well, you had a few words in it. And I told Peter Campbell, I do not understand a word you're saying. But we went on to have a great understanding of each other, accents aside, and we went on to be roommates. And my third experience of that day is as a freshman, coming onto a story program, and I was very well aware of the history of Gannon soccer before I got here, is I was welcomed into a group. And Chris, you talked about failure. I was not made to feel like a freshman. I was not made to feel like an underclassman. We were part of a team. And we were part of a special group that had business to take care of. That's one of the memories I have of this group of players. They were an extremely humble group of guys. We had a fellow who was recruited as a forward who ended up as a defender. We had a kid who was all-state midfielder who ended up as a defender. We had another fellow who was recruited as a midfielder who ended up as a defender because people moved to wherever the work needed to be done, and they just contributed to the team and they grinded it out. And in terms of helping each other, I don't remember anybody being particularly concerned with who got the credit for what happened. And we were reminiscing here over the last couple days, and you know, there were good times, right? There were some tough times. I never remember any negativity, ever, you know. But we're telling a story. Penn State, October 1989, we're playing Penn State. They're top 10 Division I, we're top 10 Division II. Games against Division I programs come few and far between, because if you do well, they don't want to play you again, right? So we have this golden opportunity, and we're playing at Penn State, and the guys hit the post 2 times. We're battling through the game. 4 minutes left in the game. Cross comes from the outside. Hands to it, and if you can touch it, you can catch it. Yeah. And it dropped, and the kid kicked it in the goal. 1-0. That was the game. And I was telling that story today, and one of the guys said, I don't really remember that. The other guy said, I kind of remember you having a good game. And I remember getting on the bus after the game, and nobody said anything negative to me. That's an example of the quality of the people that this group was. And on and off the field, they were wonderful friends. We were all, I talk about seasons of life, 4 years of university, holy smokes, we go through some changes. And we were all kind of growing up. Some were a little more mature and developed than others. We were all imperfect. Some of us were more imperfect than others. But they were a group of guys who showed grace, you know, and they were family. And that really, I think that intangible, it didn't matter what position they were. It didn't matter if they started. They challenged each other in practice. We ate together, we lived together, we supported each other off the field. And that intangible, I think, translated onto the field. You know, they've improved the whole science of statistic keeping, because like in soccer, goals, saves, goals against average, they're starting to take other statistics that show the other intangibles, but they show how people don't get statistically noticed contribute to a team. In this group, we had guys, whether they were on the game field or not, bringing the whole group along, and it was just a really special, special bunch of guys. And as a group, I think I speak for the guys. Coach talked about how well accomplished the fellows are. Gannon provided a wonderful platform for us. You know, you gave us an opportunity to have each other. You gave us an opportunity to interact with the other amazing athletes who were here, because the guys can tell you they were friends with, well, some of them were tennis players, but they were friends with tennis players. The basketball team were our friends. The wrestling team, the softball team, baseball team, had club hockey. All the athletes were friends. We hung out, you know, and it was just a really great environment here. And we had teachers, small school environment teachers who I felt cared about me as an individual, took the time with us, and Gannon provided a great platform of growth for us to move on into life. We can't thank you enough for that. I'm really humbled to be a part of this group, and I think the fellows are humbled to know that we might actually, you know, be recognized as having helped build the history of Gannon. So I'd just like to close with some of my favorite memories of playing. One, obviously, were the bus rides, because we had the bus rides to and from games, and we had the bus rides to and from practice in that little gospel church bus, the Green Hornet. The big suspense of the day was whether the bus was going to start and we were going to make it to practice. But there was a lot of fun banter going on there. The second most memorable time was that huddle up before the game, you know, because we were aware of the history of Gannon, and we were aware of what you guys built when you were here, and that we were playing and we were representing Gannon. It was important games, you know, and it was a little tense. But when you huddled up and you could feel the strength and the positivity of all the guys, you know, it allowed goofballs like me to play beyond themselves and to have an opportunity to achieve much more than they really deserve to achieve. And then the last memory, I think, was post-game. You know, soccer, it's 90 minutes of extraordinarily vigorous exertion. And science has shown that athletes need to replenish themselves with good post-game refreshment. This is not going where you think it's going. But kind of to the family aspect of it all, you know, a lot of the guys, a lot of the American kids on the team, their moms and dads came to a lot of our games. Jamie Diana's mom sat in the stands in Lock Haven and smacked that kid in the back of the head when he was back talking her son. She said he was straight. You know, we'd have a meal at Mike Skanetska's house. Chris Kehoe's parents would come. My mom and dad would take us in. Taz's parents, you know, Dave Frew's parents were always around. We had this family atmosphere that, you know, combined with the brotherhood that we had, and it was really a special time. And added on to that, my mom and dad managed to come to games, and they'd bring this high-performance drink called Aunt Rosie's Loganberry.
Yeah.
And you can't get it in a whole lot of places. And what it lacks in electrolyte and nutrition, it makes up for in pure sugar. They would bring that to us. Unfortunately, that's what they're passing out to the fellas. We didn't have enough. We wanted to bring hundreds of it to bring out to y'all. But with that, you know, we'll probably do a toast later. But the words of our toast would be to Coach, thank you so much for bringing us together. We can't thank you enough. You know, it's such a special 4 years of our life, and it's part of the foundation upon which we and our families and our lives are built. Cannot thank you enough. Thank you for your patience in dealing with us. I don't know how our parents dealt with us, and you picked up when they left off, and they were happy for you to have us. Your patience, and we thank the university for all the opportunities you gave to us, and thank you all for being here. Thanks for putting up with us.
Come on, guys.